So that was Colors in Darkness, but wait, there's more. As I keep saying horror and science fiction because sometimes the boundary lines that separate horror and science fiction are so blurred and so thin that sometimes they're non-existent. And anyone who's reading my work and others like it knows that sometimes science fiction is the evil twin of horror. So those of you who are science fiction geeks and comic book junkies and graphic novels, again, horror has so many different subgenres that I'm not done. I'm going to also give you another resource from one of my favorite Black female writers. Her name is Cerise Rennie Murphy. She is the author of the Order of the Seer trilogy that has one of the most amazing villains that I have ever read in my whole entire life. I wish he is real. I wish that he was real. He's so bad. He's like, he's villainous. And you know, I like bad guys, super villains, and evil geniuses. But anyway, she has, it's almost, she's got a website and a newsletter, but it's almost like, when you go to the website, it's almost like a matchmaking service. The site is called Nurazu, and she can explain it better than me. So let's check out her trailer, okay?
Hi, my name is Cerise Rennie Murphy, and I am an independent science fiction author and the founder of Nurazu. The idea for Nurazu started in about 2012 when I attended my first Comic-Con, which was New York Comic-Con. But what I found was there was this wonderful community of fans, science fiction fans, who were open to new artists and new authors and really looking to discover content that they couldn't find anywhere else. It really opened my mind and about the possibilities of what was open to me as an artist if I was brave enough to go out and find my audience.
Hi everybody, Cerise Rennie Murphy. I am here at my booth at New York Comic Con 2016. But you know, I'm not just a sci-fi author, I'm also a fan. And so we're gonna walk around and I'm gonna show you what I love about comic conventions. So come on. First thing I love about Comic-Cons is just, doesn't matter what you're wearing or what you feel like, you can just be who you are.
After the convention's gone, there's really no place online that brings together the dynamic mixture of comics and graphic novels, books and film. The idea for an online platform that could bring together the best in speculative fiction, independent artists, and the fans who love what they do together just kind of emerged from my experience as an independent author going to comic conventions over the last 4 years.
Five years ago, I got a vision for my first sci-fi story, and I didn't even know if I could write it, but I knew I wanted to try, because when you've been a sci-fi fan forever, and you get an original idea, you do not drop that ball. So I decided to try to write it, and I'm on my sixth book now. So the first lesson is, once you start writing, you can't stop. that you should try it too.
Nurazu is needed because as an independent speculative fiction artist, and as an indie artist in general, one of your biggest challenges is finding your audience. So even though there are platforms like Amazon or film festivals where you could potentially, or Comixology, where you could have your work, having your work on a platform and having it be discovered by your target audience are two completely different things. And as an indie artist, the challenge of rising above all of the noise and all the other artists and talents that are there, both known and unknown, so that your target audience discovers your work is a real challenge. But at Nurazu, that's our main job.
It's a constant struggle to kind of deal with the social media algorithms because they're changing all the time, so knowing how to play that game is important. making new connections, you know, joining new communities, it's a lot of time, you know, hitting these conventions is a big investment.
So these days, people don't trust advertising as much as they used to. They go by word of mouth. So luckily, fans like what we do and they tell their friends about it and that spreads and it's organic, but it is slow. Doing things, advertising especially digitally, it's never been so easy to advertise many people in the world, but that also means there's more competition for people's attention. I have to confess, I'm not brilliant at it. I tend to rely on fans and word of mouth.
A lot of the problem that the independent publishers have is that there are so many of them, which there should be because it is hard to get your artwork out there, but because there's so many, it's kind of hard to zigzag in between and pull out your favorites. When you meet a comic book artist, ask them, what are you reading right now? An artist is not going to tell you to go look at garbage art. You know, they're going to tell you where you can see the best of the best.
So can you briefly say a project that's in the works or just released?
Next, I'm going to be putting together an online platform for sci-fi and comic culture fans like you guys to help you find indie creators that you will love.
Eurazu is a game changer because we cut out the middleman. We stop asking for permission to share our content with the audience that loves it the most. And that's true across comic books, graphic novels, artwork. We bring for you an audience that loves what you do to the work that you put your heart into.
Using Neuratu would help increase my range of connections. It's important to interact with the community. Neuratu would allow me to do that.
Neuratu is a very interesting concept because it's a platform designed to find the best content for you. So depending on your taste, it recommends things. And because you interact with these people, you trust their opinions, you can find stuff that you know you'll enjoy too. I'm very excited to see what happens with it.
Well, the first thing you can do to support Neuratu is go to our website at www.neurazu.com and sign up as a fan or a creator. And if you're both, no worries, we'd love to have you in both spaces. But tell us, as a fan or a creator, what content you love and what content you create so that we can create those meaningful matches between the fans who are looking for your work and the independent artists who create it.
See, I told you it was awesome. So a couple of years ago when I was on a panel, I got teased for yelling at white people in horror movies. It was pretty bad. Good thing I can take a joke. But the woman who was teasing me, she asked me, she was like, you know, what do you think a horror movie with an all-black cast directed by a black film director would look like? And I'm glad that you asked that question. I didn't have the answer a couple of years ago, but I do have it now. And thanks to a film writer named Bree Newsom, we're going to watch a screener of her movie called Wake. And it is kind of like a love story, so it kind of fits in the Valentine's women in horror, Black History Month genre. So I think it's gonna be a good fit. So I love this movie. I hope you guys love it too. Again, this is Bree Newsom's screener for Wake. So let's watch that too. Can't wait to hear what you guys think.
The first man ever lived, God made from the dirt. And ever since then, every man east of Eden goes back to being dirt when he dies. So around here, when it come time to bury a man, the church folk go to the dead man's house to help his soul pass over. All through the night, keeping watch as good Christians do, or having a wake, as they call it.
Brothers and sisters, we come here today to bid farewell to our good friend and neighbor, Brother Ezra Giles, and we offer our sympathy to his kindly daughter, Charmaine. Now, brothers and sisters, today I ask that you say a special prayer for Charmaine in her time of need. Let's come together as a family. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, brothers and sisters.
Look at her, poor thing. She don't even know what to do with herself.
Well, what you expect? Her daddy kept her cooped up like some old hen.
He was trying to keep that fox out of there.
Maybe it's not too late for her to find somebody. All she needs is a good, solid man.
Well, she better hurry up. She's about to be an old maid.
Please, Charmaine passed the old maid mark a while ago, if you ask me. She just lucky her daddy died when he did. While there's still time to get married over his dead body.
You're terrible.
Now everybody knows if you're fixing to gossip, you gotta have a little dirt on somebody.
Same as you.
And everybody knows if you're fixing to bury, you gotta throw a little dirt on somebody. But don't everybody know that if you're fixing to conjure, it's best to take a little dirt from somebody. If and you want something bad enough that praying takes too long, they say there's a way to make it happen yourself by forcing the hand of nature, or working roots, as they call it.
Like God said to Moses at the burning bush, get them sandals off those ashy feet. This here land is holy.
I ain't Moses.
Then why are you in the wilderness?
I come to get what I want.
A man. Well, you gotta get one to get one. Ezra Lewis Giles. How'd your daddy die?
In his sleep.
Charmaine.
Bury the box.
Charmaine. Allow me to introduce myself. I am whoever you wish me to be. Compliment to your good taste.
Wait, now it might be just a little bit too tight.
Shall we?
Did you turn the light off?
I don't know about your mama's, but Miss Maddie's. Ooh, girl.
I mean, she's taught me most of what I know about baking. Who's After that? All, we can only assume.
Who's that?
Don't reckon
you
I know.
Anything about it?
Well,
it's Charmaine.
Uh-oh. What you mean? Well, looks like that fox got in after all.
Looks like we have company. Charmaine, dear, look who's here.
Why, you know who's here.
Charmaine has told me all about you, lovely lady.
Hey, Bootsy. Hey, Florence. How y'all is? Hey, Ruth.
Is that Miss Bootsy?
The nicest, most Christian woman in town?
Well, I reckon so.
Charmaine has told me so much about you. Have you ever been to First Baptist in Wilmington?
Wilmington?
Yes, ma'am. That's where
we got married. After meeting at her aunt's house.
Oh, so y'all are cousins?
No, ma'am. We don't do that kind of thing in the city.
Well, Charmaine said she had kin, but I didn't realize she had any close relatives still living.
Well, it's my job to keep Auntie Grace living. Being that I'm a physician.
Did you see the look on their face when you told them you was a physician?
Nope.
I only saw you. Mrs.
Doctor.
Come on.
Adam and Eve were not able to hide from God. He always knows about everything we do. It made him very angry. What are you doing up? You should be in bed, dear.
What you doing with the light on?
Just reading a little of the good book here. Oh, I'm sorry. But we certainly wouldn't want anybody to know the truth.
Well, don't you want to come on and go to bed?
Certainly. Something wrong, my dear? This is our honeymoon in Wilmington. Or is it Charlotte? How about Paris? I got it. The Fiji Islands. It is whatever you want. Dearest, sweetest Charlotte.
What's the matter?
One ain't enough for you?
This ain't right.
Well, that's an opinion. But the fact is, you made him. He's yours.
No! He ain't what I wanted.
Was he handsome? With big green eyes? Did he dress real nice? And his new eye, too? Did you like the Bible say? And really get to know you.
He ain't a man.
Most of them ain't. And he sure didn't come with his mom.
He is a monster!
You the one chose to conjure among the damned. You went to the eye doctor to get your teeth fixed. Don't like the results. So what you want now?
I don't want him.
Ain't your hands dirty enough?
You take him back.
He ain't mine to take. He your roof work.
I don't want no more of this. You take him back now, you hear me?
You dig, or my land is gonna be the one I want.
I'll bury your ass so deep. Got me lantern just to find your soul.
Better learn what's best with you, girl. Or some goddamn ass.
Ain't my job to pull a weed in your yard. You want it gone? You do it yourself.
Charmaine, dear, why do you look like a mouse that just got his back broken and trapped? Could it be the way you stay hanging behind that door? What you got there?
Sweet tea for you.
How did he die exactly?
And asleep.
He's gone to a better place.
Lady, you'd like to spend some time alone with him before the burial?
You sure you're gonna be all right?
The Lord God formed man from the dust of the earth, and to the dust of the earth we commit this body. But ye not forget that the spirit of man, the life of man, was formed from the very breath of God. And that spirit of life shall return to the Heavenly Father from whence it came.
Thought we'd come by and holler at you for a bit. How you holding up, honey?
Can't sleep. It's always kicking. Well, it's keeping me awake.
You'll sound like a boy. It feel like a boy to you?
If I told you what it felt like, you wouldn't believe me.
Oh, I bet you I would.
I have two boys of my own. Trust me, the next time you sleep, it's gonna be your wake.
Now you can trust and believe I yelled at her too. She pissed me all the way off. She should have known better. But anyway, that was Wake. I leave your comments below and let me know how you guys liked that. I do have one other film that I want to share with you guys, but this post is getting pretty lengthy. So this is going to be homework. Again, this is a film with two Black stars. It was written and directed by a Black director and writer, and it has zombies in it. So for you zombie fans out there, this is going to be one that you're going to like. But this post is getting pretty lengthy, so this is going to be homework. And so at your earliest convenience, come back to this post and click the link below and check out a movie called Danger World. And so that was today's post. I hope you guys had a blast hanging out with me and Horror Addicts, and I will see you next time around. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out with me. I know it took a lot of your time today. I'm rambling because I'm nervous, but thanks for hanging out, and I'll have like two or three more videos for you guys this month, all revolving around Black history, Black women in horror, women in horror, and Valentine's Day. So I will see you guys soon. Have a super good day, and don't work too hard.
When we come to see